All right, I'm Dr. Tim Durkin here with Janet Peterson with the Base Medical Team. We're just going to go through some of the points of performance on securing your patient into the vacuum mattress. So what we've done here is we've already gone ahead and used standard moves to place our patient on the vacuum mattress. Obviously, Aaron today is an actor. He doesn't have any actual injuries. If he had, say, a leg injury or we were concerned about a neck injury, we might have a rescuer kind of trying to stabilize those injuries while we were potentially moving him a little bit as we adjust these straps and so on and so forth. You also notice that we're working on a tarp today. Some of that's a practical consideration because it's pretty muddy out where we're filming here today, but that's actually a very reasonable thing to do in an actual operation scenario, particularly if you're in a desert environment where there might be cactus or sharp rocks that could potentially damage your equipment. Also, you want to try to keep your equipment clean. If you're going to be packaging your patient into a litter, then this tarp could then form the basis of weather protection of your hypothermia wrap or so forth. So it's certainly not an entirely contrived thing for our demonstration today to have a tarp down on the ground when working with this type of equipment. So what we're going to do now that we have Aaron properly positioned, we've indexed his head to the top of the mattress. He's basically in the middle of it right now, is we'll go ahead and just apply the straps. And so Janet is going to do the lower part. I'll do the upper part. And the straps on these this model are nicely color-coded for us. And we want to get them snug but not uncomfortable. So, you know, 2-3 fingers of comfortable space underneath that strap is probably right what we're looking for. Depending on what arm injuries we might be concerned about for Aaron, or if we wanted to have an arm out for vascular access or vital signs or something like that, I might choose to package his arms in or outside of the mattress. That's going to be dependent on, you know, your personal preference and what's going on with your patient. So I'll go ahead and secure this strap and make that snug here. Aaron, how's that doing? Good. Okay. Don't want to make anything around the chest too tight, particularly in an injured patient. You don't want to have anything that's going to make their breathing very difficult. This newer model has diagonal straps, which do a really good job of staying off of the neck here in this newer model of vacuum mattress. In some of the older models, they don't do quite as good a job of that. So what you can do is if you have a horizontal strap kind of at belly or mid-chest level, take the strap that would go across the neck and just thread it through a lower strap so that it doesn't come straight across his neck. Instead, it kind of dives down and then goes back up, again, keeping your airway clear. So I'll go ahead and attach this last strap over his chest. I'm going to get that snug, make sure that I'm not impeding his respiratory movement of his thoracic cage. Janet's going to go ahead and attach our head strap there. And then particularly if we're concerned about some type of a head or neck injury, it's important to stabilize and kind of mold the mattress while we're deploying the vacuum to kind of make sure that conforms well and give some good stability and spinal motion restriction around the head and the neck. So now we have our straps in, we're satisfied with how they're positioned and the degree of tightness that we have. They're not causing undue discomfort. So I'm ready to deploy my vacuum. So I've got my pump. I'll go ahead and check my valve. I'll go ahead and make sure my valve is closed all the way clockwise until it's snug and hand tight. Go ahead and insert the working end of the pump. It just friction fits. There's no kind of lock or anything like that. And now I'll just go ahead and start to run my pump here and go ahead and deploy the vacuum on the mattress. As I do this, I can go ahead and kind of just do some additional molding here. Particularly if I have other rescuers, that's something else they could be doing while I do this. And I'll go ahead and just continue to run this pump until I start to see that the beads become very prominent on the black side of the patient side of the mattress. And I'll start to feel a decent amount of resistance here in the pump. And I know that we've now got an adequate vacuum. So I'll go ahead and detach the pump. Keep your pump handy during a long evacuation. Sometimes if the valve gets manipulated as the litter moves, you may need to redeploy the vacuum or you may need to repackage or adjust the patient. So don't lose track of this during a prolonged evacuation. Now that this is tight, the vacuum's been deployed, I'll just go ahead and put the cap over top of the valve. And at this point, I can go ahead and grab the handles, and we're ready to move. If we haven't already put Aaron into a litter, you could just do all this already in the litter. We could move him into a litter. We could make a short move over moderate terrain to an ambulance, another ground vehicle, or a helicopter. Thank you.